Namaste.
Thank you all for joining me. This is Deborah Cohen here, and today we're going to be working on some strong abdominal work, which will help to strengthen the lower back. We may be doing some roll-ins, that kind of thing. So if you have a period today or lower back issues, it may not be the right video for you to practice today. Maybe have a look at one of the others that I've got up on the channel. Otherwise, we're going to start off with some Kapalabhati breathing breath of fire, which will help to tone the abdominal muscles, but it's a cleansing breath, so it will keep the sinuses clear. Now, when we do Kapalabhati breathing, you want to be focusing on the out breath. It's a slower version of Bhastrika, so we're going to breathe in slowly, but breathe out vigorously, in and out through the nose. And as you breathe out, you want to feel that your belly is moving back towards the spine, you're snapping it back towards the spine. So have a look at the video first and then we'll do it together. So if you place one hand onto the abdomen, it will just help to remind you to snap the belly back. You're breathing in slowly and you're breathing out vigorously. And as you breathe out, you snap it back. Okay, we are going to be doing the chin lock, and you may want to get a tissue if you feel you need to blow your nose before you start. Okay, so we'll do 10. When we finish 10, we will hold the breath in and we'll draw up the Mula Bandha, which is the pelvic floor lock, and we'll draw up the Uddiyana Bandha, the abdominal lock in the body. So let's start. Chin down towards that notch between your collarbones, and make the neck nice and long as you bring your chin down and close your eyes. Take your hand onto your abdomen, and then off we go, breathing in, and as you breathe out, snapping the belly back. And then take a deep breath in, pull up your pelvic floor muscles, pull up your abdominal muscles, Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, hold it, and then release. Open your eyes and raise your head. Just make sure that you're not feeling lightheaded. If you are, then don't breathe so deeply, maybe take it a little bit more gently. Let's have another go. Jala Bandha chin lock. Hand onto the abdomen again if you wish, and then off we go. Deep breath in, hold it, pull up your Mula Bandha, your Uddiyana Bandha, right up underneath the rib cage, and then release. Slowly open your eyes and raise your head. You'll have one more round. Chin down, chest lifting up, shoulders back and down, hand onto the abdomen, and off you go. Deep breath in, pull up the pelvic floor muscles, the abdominal muscles, in and up. Keep your chin lock, and then release all three bandhas and come off your blocks and lie yourself down. Of course, if you are not doing Virasana for reasons of knee problems, you can always do that sitting in a chair or just sitting cross legs. Bring the feet into Baddha Konasana now and just rest. Always rest after you've done any strong breathing exercises. Few normal breaths. In your Baddha Konasana, just make sure your tailbone is long. Lift your hips up and move your tailbone towards your heels.
And then bring the knees together. Take the feet hip-width apart. Have your palms down to the floor. And just squeeze in your pelvic floor muscles. So you want to feel that they're I always think of a figure of eight. So you're drawing them in all around the vagina, the anus, if you're a man, the scrotum and the anus, not just the vagina or the scrotum. So pull in and up. And that's your mula bandha, your pelvic floor lock. And then release. Now the abdominal lock. Draw the navel to the spine, belly button to the spine, and the spine moves towards the floor. But you want to feel like the abdomen is lifting in and up as if it's coming underneath the rib cage. And then release. And then do both together. So pelvic floor and abdomen, mula bandha, uddiyana bandha. Pressing the lower back into the floor, squeezing in and up. And then release. Hug your knees in towards your chest, have a little roll from side to side. And then roll all the way over and come into Adho Mukha Virasana, child's pose. So sitting back on your heels. If your bottom doesn't reach your heels, you can also put a block or two between your heels and your hips. Stretching your arms forward, flattening the hands and letting the head come down. And imagine that you're pushing the mat away with your hands. If you want to, grab hold of the sides of the mat and pull the mat apart and push it away from you as you let your head come down. Now draw your abdomen in. You'll feel you get your hips a little bit closer to your heels when you draw your abdomen in. And then from there, just to warm up the whole body, let's do a couple of dog head downs. So up you come. You can start to pedal out the feet, just stretching and straightening one leg at a time. All the time, keep the abdominal muscles in and up, and then stretch both heels down. Lift the kneecaps, lift the thighs. Push the mat away with your hands, and try to make sure that you're rolling the weight towards the thumb side of your hand. And then release, back down into Adho Mukha Virasana. And then come up once more. So from here, abdominal muscles drawing in, toes turning under, and lift the hips up high. Let's have the heels high, the kneecaps lifting, the thighs lifting, buttocks high. Move your chest closer to your legs, and then slowly stretch the heels down. And then from there, walk your feet towards your hands. Have them hip-width apart. And you can either take your hands onto your shins to lift the head and lift the chest to look forward. Or if you have that flexibility, take your hands onto the floor. But a concave upper back, still drawing the abdomen in. And then go all the way down. And let's hold the elbows. So let the gravity, the weight of your head and your arms draw you down. The sides of the body drawing down, the elbows towards the floor. Deep breath in. And as you exhale, try and stretch a little further down. Keep the kneecaps lifting, keep the thighs rolling in. From there, lift the head and lift the chest. Take your hands onto your shins. Lift your head. And coming up, all the way up, either with bent knees or a flat back. You'll know that if you've got back problems. Okay.